tonight. I'm Judith Rizzio, and I happen to be very fortunate to be the coordinator of CAPS Archive, along with being the manager of volunteer resources, which I'm very proud of. And I just want to just give some quick thank yous and also to point out some very fun people in the audience that you hopefully you'll be able to talk to after this event. Very quickly, though, there are some very important thanks. First, the Multnomah County Library has been just an amazing player and collaborator with us this year. They started, we wanted to do this last year. We said, give us a year, this would take a while. Little do we know what it would take, but there was a person that was with us all along. She's been my helper like you can't believe. Coy View, right back there, Coy with the library. Actually, before he came to CAP with his skills, he was George Lucas's archivist for 7 years. I'm not kidding you. And then he stepped even higher and became ours. Anyway, Alan Giles, thank you so much.
May the force be with you.
There's many a CAP staffer in this room tonight, and if there's something I can't say enough is that working for CAP is not always easy. It's a lot of tough stuff, but the reason why we're able to do this is because there's such amazingly dedicated, smart, fun, and compassionate people that I get to work with, and I want to thank every single one of you, you know who you are, for all that. They've been so helpful with me along the way, so I really love all of you. Thank you. And then I have some really a fun thing. There are three people here tonight that have been a long time part of the history of CAP, and I want to just introduce them. First of all, in front of me here, John Terrell. John, by the way, we didn't nab him soon enough. His archives are housed at the Oregon Historical Society, otherwise they'd be with us today. But John has an amazing history and has done so much. I got to know John many years ago at our house. He was on the board there, but he was there from the very beginning in one of the earliest groups that now create CAP today. So this is John right here. And then there are two people that are responsible really solely for that display right there. The t-shirts. A dear friend, he was a volunteer at our house when I was running their department there years ago. His name is Dustin Posner, and it was when we did a call out for the archives in 2010. He called me up and said, look at Judith, you know, I have these two t-shirts. However, they're in my dust rag bag, and they're pretty messed up. And I said, I want them, just send them our way. And so these t-shirts, are extremely important, and why they are so very special, and especially for Dustin to hand them over to us, is that his partner, who died of AIDS, wore these at our very first events of CAP, and I mean the very first, and I want to acknowledge Dustin. Will you please stand up, please? Vaughn Frick, will you please stand up, Vaughn? I want to say there's going to be one more thing happening here in the U.S. Bank Room in the library. It's We Are Survivors. This is Wednesday, December 3rd from 6 to 7:30. And long-term HIV survivors from Let's Kick Ass PDX. Ass means AIDS. survivor syndrome, and they will share their personal stories. So please, if you have a free night, it's going to be very powerful, 6 to 7:30 here at the library. And I just want to just close up by saying that there are so many people that are here tonight. And by us being here, we hold them. We hold their memory, and we also hold the hope that all the work they did and all the future work that will be done by all of us here will not at all go in vain, because we're going to see this thing to the end. I thank you very much. There's more food, and please enjoy this. And if you have friends who haven't seen this, this will be up for one more week. Please tell them about it and drive home safe. And thank you so very much.